Parliamentary Representative for Vieux Fort North, Moses Jabatiste, says he has conducted numerous health education programs in the constituency, and he knows that his SLP parliamentarians are doing the same in their areas. However, Mr. Jabatiste, who is also the SLP spokesman on health, thinks there is more the government can do to combat the spread. He called on the government to undertake the necessary cleanup activities in the various communities, such as the clearing of drains.
We know that there have been confirmed deaths as a result of the dengue fever, and we have called on the government to do what it must. So, for example, there are many areas, especially low-lying areas, that the government has to take care of in terms of clearing up drains and ensuring that heavy equipment is used to do what they must do.
St. Lucia has recorded over 500 cases of dengue fever, prompting calls by the government on the public to play their part in the fight against the fever. Simple steps such as turning over empty containers to prevent them from collecting stagnant water and covering water storage containers can make a big difference.
But we have also been encouraging individuals, residents, to clean their areas and to clean their homes and so on.
Just earlier this month, Chief Environmental Health Officer Parker Ragnanan called on the public to take steps to eradicate all breeding grounds from their surroundings. He cited spare tires, old appliances, scattered garbage, bottles and coconut shells, which can all provide the habitat for the Aedes aegypti mosquitoes.
But there is so much that a ministry, a department can do. The question now is, what can you do? What can every solution do? And so we've spoken about the protective measures that you can take. I've already mentioned about playing your part, removing breeding sites for mosquitoes. But we also need to be responsible. And that responsibility means that we must take personal responsibility for our health and our well-being and that of our family. Knowing the times of the day that the mosquito come out, we need to be vigilant.
The ministry also gave some tips to avoid getting bitten by the mosquito. They include wearing long clothing and using insect repellents.
Persons with symptoms tend to attempt to manage their symptoms. For instance, the fever or the pain. And from the Ministry of Health and Wellness, we encourage persons that if you are going to take medication to manage your fever and pain, to use paracetamol and to avoid the use of medication like ibuprofen, aspirin, and other drugs within this class, what we call non-steroidal anti-inflammatory agents, because these medications tend to cause bleeding or can worsen bleeding in a person with dengue.
Mosquitoes relish breeding in fresh, stagnated water, laying their eggs just above the surface, and usually breed at dusk and dawn. As a result, the ministry has embarked on fogging exercises during these times. To date, 3 persons have died from dengue fever. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas.